Good morning, North Star Kids. I'm Dustin, and you know what time it is? It's Sunday Online in the Hub! I'm so glad that you joined us this morning. The entire month, we've been talking about determination. Determination is deciding it's worth it to finish what you started. So you may have noticed that I'm covered in sticky notes. That's because I need a reminder that anytime I'm in a sticky situation, that I need to have determination and I can get unstuck. That's not always easy, but with God's help, I know that I can get out of any sticky situation that I get into. And I believe that today, you're gonna love our sticky game called Beard Masterpiece. But wait, you guys aren't here with me to play my game of determination. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I believe I've got myself in some type of sticky situation, and I just don't know how to get out of it. But wait, I must have determination to figure this out. But as I look around the room, there's the camera lady or Miss Christie. I believe Miss Christie would love our beard masterpiece game.
Dustin, what are you doing? I'm not supposed to be on the video this week.
Oh, Miss Christie, I decided I needed a little bit of help with my epic determination game.
I'm not really prepared to play a game today.
Oh, Miss Christie, I don't think this is a good idea. You're so sweet.
I really think I should go.
Put this on.
Oh my God, what are you going to make me do?
Just put this on. And you want to wear a shower cap?
What are you doing to my hair?
And goggles. Here, put those on. Hey, kids, do you think we need this? Don't move, Miss Christie. Don't
move. Why are you taping my feet? Help me.
I think we've got it. So, Miss Christie, here's how today's going to work in our epic game of determination. We're going to play Beard Masterpiece, where we use shaving cream to build Miss Christie a nice beard. You're stuck, Miss Christie, and it's hard to get unstuck. And so today we're going to build a nice big beard, and we're going to use Fruit Loops to decorate our beard. Well, the only issue is I normally need you kids to help me out because I have at least two competitors. But today, it's just me. Miss Christie, you ready?
No.
Ready?
No.
Me. Help set. Me. Go! All right, Miss Christie.
Wipe out.
This beard. Look at this beard. It's going well. Now the Fruit Loops. Miss Christie, are you ready for the ultimate beard? Oh, Miss Christie, the determined face is awesome. And time! Look at that beard, kids! Miss Christie, I think you have the most wonderful beard I have ever seen. I am so glad that Miss Christie had the ultimate determination today. I mean, look at that beard. And I know as we study the Bible story for today that you're going to learn even more about determination. And so before we let Miss Nina come up and teach us, all right, kids, everybody get on your feet and let's get ready for some praise and worship.
Take my hand, you're the hero, Jesus. You're the one who everyone. We are so glad you're here today. We have missed your sweet faces here in the hub, but you know what? We're glad that we can gather together online. Now, this month, we've been talking about determination, and determination is deciding it's worth it to finish what you started. Now, I guess you've probably noticed I have on all of these medals, and I've got these trophies here. Have you guys ever won an award or a medal or a trophy? What did you do to get that award? Did you have to try really hard? Did you have to study? Did you have to practice every day? Well, whatever you did, I bet it took a lot of determination. And you know, the Bible tells us that Jesus' followers, people that believe in Jesus, they're like running a race. It's a race for life. And of course, we want to run a race that pleases God. So in today's story, we're going to learn about a man who ran his race for Jesus. So we've been making our way through God's big story. And we started at the very beginning. But now this month, we're picking up after Jesus went to heaven when the early church was beginning. Now, our story is in the book of Acts. And this is on the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit came to fill a room of believers. They were able to speak in languages that they didn't know so that they could share the good news of Jesus. And there was about 3,000 people who became believers. Then later, Peter and John started to share the good news of Jesus. All in all, there were more than 5,000 people who became followers of Jesus. That is a lot of people. Now, some of the people needed special care. Some of the people weren't able to do things for themselves. They needed food and they needed special help. So what do you think that the believers did about that? You're right. They helped. You know, the apostles, the people who had walked with Jesus while he was here on earth, they made a plan and they chose 7 wise men who listened to and followed God's Holy Spirit to help make sure that people had the things that they needed. They made sure that they had some food. Now, one of those guys, his name was Stephen. Now, do you think that Stephen was a good guy or a bad guy? Let's use this for a clue. You're right. Stephen was a great guy. He was a really, really good guy. The Bible says that Stephen was a really good guy who was full of faith and full of the Holy Spirit. And when someone needed help, everyone thought of Stephen. And more people believed in Jesus as the apostles continued to teach. Stephen and 6 other men helped make sure that everyone had what they need, that they were all cared for. Now, Stephen was doing the right thing, but some of the religious leaders started to argue with him. And the Holy Spirit gave him the wisdom that he needed to be able to answer. The religious leaders didn't like this one bit. So guess what they did? They schemed against Stephen. And in secret, they convinced some men to lie about Stephen. And they started saying that people had heard Stephen speak evil things against Moses. And that was a big deal. But they said that Stephen even said things against God. Well, when the people heard these lies, they weren't sure what to think. How could this man of God say such things? When the religious leaders heard how the people were stirred up, what do you think they did? The religious leaders had Stephen arrested. They knew that the rumors that they were saying were lies, and so they took him to their gathering known as the Sanhedrin, and Stephen was put on trial. Well, the religious leaders interviewed the men who lied about Stephen. They said that they heard Stephen speak all these evil things against the law of Moses and the Holy Temple. Stephen could have gotten angry, and he could have yelled at the people that were lying about him, but instead, he was calm and at peace. Oh, like that. Acts 6:15 says his face was like the face of an angel. Stephen didn't worry about what others were saying about him because he knew the truth. And Stephen wanted the others to understand the truth of Jesus. He knew that God was with him, and so he was filled with so much courage, even though he knew the religious leaders could kill him. Now, Stephen spoke with boldness, and he knew that Jesus was the most important part of God's plan that had set in motion well before Abraham. And he says in Acts 7:51, "You stubborn people, you won't obey, you won't listen. You're just like your people of long ago. You always oppose the Holy Spirit. Was there ever a prophet your people didn't try to hurt? They even killed those who told you about the coming of the blameless one. And now you have handed him over to his enemies. You have murdered him." How do you think the religious leaders reacted when Stephen said this? Even though Stephen spoke the truth about Jesus, the religious leaders were very angry. God knew what was in their hearts. So he gave Stephen a vision of heaven. God allowed Stephen to see something that no one else could see. Stephen looked up and saw Jesus standing with God. Can you imagine seeing what heaven looks like? But the religious leaders, they didn't want to hear anything, not another word from Stephen. They covered their ears and started to yell. Well, I'll tell you what happened next, but it was really sad. The religious leaders dragged Stephen out, and they started throwing stones at Stephen, trying to kill him. While they did this, Stephen prayed to God. He asked God not to hold this horrible act against them. Matter of fact, he prayed and he asked God to forgive them of their sin. Even though Stephen had done what was right, he died that day. You know, Jesus said to live out his love everywhere, no matter what, in God's power. And Stephen had continued to share God's love all the way until his last breath. Now, of course, what happened in the end was terrible. And it may not be how you were expecting it to go. But here's the good news. That isn't the end of the story. Do you remember when Stephen had that vision of heaven? Remember how Jesus was standing next to God and he saw a picture of heaven? Well, Stephen knew that when he died, that he would be in heaven with Jesus. Stephen was able to keep going because he knew no matter what, that God was with him. And that is something that you and I have to remember too. Our bottom line is that we can keep going because God knows the end of the story. All right, well, we know for sure how God's one big story ends. We know that in the end, those who follow Jesus will be in heaven one day with God. So friends, just keep running your race, keep trying your best, and use your determination because the end of our race, we are promised heaven. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this wonderful story of Stephen. It must have been so hard for him to have that faith, to keep going, but you know the end of the story and you will help us. You will help us get to the end of that race so we can get what is promised to us, heaven. Help us to stay determined and to stay encouraged. We thank you so much for your love and for the way you walk us through our lives. We pray all of these things in Jesus' name, amen. Well, we're so glad that you guys joined us today. Please make sure that you follow us on North Star Kids Facebook page or find us on our YouTube channel. And we will see you next week.